You're watching WHTN, ABC 27. Now, live from the station working for you, this is ABC 27 News at 6.
I, Barack Hussein Obama, do solemnly swear.
This is a moment in history, and people get it.
I'm tearful because my dad is not here to see this, and I'm not going to cry. But within my heart, I'm smiling. I'm smiling, and I'm smiling for my dad.
Today, I say to you that the challenges we face are real. They are serious, and they are many. They will not be met easily or in a short span of time. But know this, America, they will be met.
Good evening. I'm Dennis Owens, one of the powerful lines there.
Definitely. I'm Alicia Richards. We're glad you're with us. President Barack Obama launched a new era of hope at his inauguration today.
Elizabeth Manresa takes a look at today's history-making event, the swearing-in of America's first African-American president. We go live to Washington, D.C., our nation's capital, the scene of today's history.
Well, I can tell you thousands of visitors here in the nation's capital are in a very festive mood. I don't know if you can hear behind me, but the inaugural parade is still going on, and the celebration really tonight is just getting started. Before hundreds of thousands of people line from the Capitol to the Lincoln Memorial, an historic transfer of power in the nation's capital.
I, Barack Hussein Obama, do solemnly swear.
Standing next to his wife and with his hand on the same Bible Abraham Lincoln used nearly 150 years ago, Barack Obama took the oath of office, becoming the nation's first African-American commander-in-chief.
I stand here today humbled by the task before us, grateful for the trust you've bestowed.
Acknowledging the road ahead will be bumpy, President Obama said he remains hopeful.
The challenges we face are real. They are serious and they are many. They will not be met easily or in a short span of time. But know this, America, they will be met.
The unprecedented inauguration marks the end of the Bush administration. President and Mrs. Obama said farewell to the former First Family. Along the inaugural parade route, excitement after those wishing to welcome the First Family got a surprise glimpse of the President and First Lady. Then a tribute to the Obama family who looked on from a secured viewing station. But in the midst of the celebration, concern over Massachusetts Senator Ted Kennedy, already suffering from brain cancer, he was rushed to a Washington hospital after collapsing at a lunch for President Obama. Doctors say he's doing fine. Now, there are 10 official inaugural balls set to take place tonight, and it is expected that the President and First Lady will attend each one of them. Reporting live in Washington, I'm Elizabeth Manresa. Back to you.
Many students watched the inauguration in school today in Spring Garden Township, York County. Lunchtime at Indian Rock Elementary became Living History 101. We asked them what they thought.
He's like a strong leader, I think.
That I will bear
and
true faith and
I think that he'll do great for our country.
This is our 44th president of the United States, and he's a half African American. He's going to make history.
And when the actual swearing-in took place, the whole class stood up. Well, some people watched today's inauguration at work. Others did so while looking for work. Job seekers watched the ceremony at the CareerLink Center in Lebanon. The jobless rate is at a 16-year high, but many of the unemployed we talked with are hopeful President Obama can begin to turn things around.
I think it's unbelievable, man. To have the amount of people that we have in here today taking notice, it just goes to show that people are real interested in what this new president of the United States has to say.
Things are changing. Yeah. Because, you know, we have a new president, so they think a lot of things are going to change, so it looks better.
And by the way, if you're looking for a job, you can go to abc27.com and find the CareerLink Center in your area.
My assignment on this historic day was to watch Barack Obama's speech with students and scholars at Gettysburg College and put it in proper historical perspective. An assignment that got a lot more interesting when the new president mentioned the town by name. Gettysburg has borne witness to history. Here, some of the earliest shots were fired in the war for racial equality. And Gettysburg once again witnessed history as students packed the college ballroom to watch a more peaceful transfer of power. An important chapter in a story that began 150 years ago in fields around the school.
our first African-American president being here in Gettysburg. You know, the Civil War is central to the African-American struggle for freedom.
The new president thrilled this group with one line.
For us, they fought and died in places like Concord and Gettysburg.
We often say that Gettysburg is the best-known small town in the world, and it was really nice to get an affirmation of that in the inaugural speech.
Alan Gelzo is head of Civil War Studies at the college, but he was struck by Obama's reference to another Pennsylvania place, George Washington's winter struggles at Valley Forge.
This is a Valley Forge moment and calling on Americans to rise to the example set by Washington.
But Obama's presidency isn't just for Americans. Susan Yabe is a sophomore exchange student from Kenya. She says the son of a Kenyan becoming president is huge in her homeland.
It's been even way crazier than it has been in the U.S. And even just this morning, I was told that in Obama's dad's village, they slaughtered two bulls to celebrate the inauguration.
Is that big, slaughtering two bulls?
That's a very big deal.
And the very big lesson on this day, history doesn't always have to be studied. Sometimes it can be watched. And the inauguration may have overshadowed three swearing-in ceremonies in Harrisburg today. Taking the oath of office were Auditor General Jack Wagner, now serving his second term, Tom Corbett, sworn into his second term as Attorney General, and Rob McCord, who became the state's new treasurer. Don't be surprised if two of those, Corbett and Wagner, run for governor. But that's tomorrow's story. Today's story is they got sworn in.